Mike Scoggin just asked me to identify myself. I'm Stephen Douglas Price. And he instructs me to indicate why I should be elected to the town council. Is that correct?
That's correct.
The reason I have run for town council and mayor is the same reason I'm running today. I've run several times in the past. My interest and my concern is for my hometown, Georgetown, where I was born and raised, and where I have a lot of friends and a lot of kinfolk for whom I want the very best. And in my opinion, they're not getting the very best for a whole lot of reasons. And most of those reasons are distractions caused by government. I include the public schools. If the government and its policies would not distract people from their own devices at home, people would learn to live off of the land near where they reside. I have to also, another big distraction is Detroit and the motor manufacturing industry, which has caused people to become motorists and has destroyed pedestrianism in not only in Georgetown but worldwide. And of course now Detroit has expanded into a worldwide global automotive industry, of which Georgetown is a part due to Toyota. I would, as a council person, want to make pedestrians and farmers, pedestrian crop workers out of my friends, my family, and everyone in Georgetown, because that's the best, healthiest way to live. Yes, Mike Scoggin just asked me, did I read the survey that he published in the News Graphic, right?
Yes.
Part of it, anyway, big part of it. Yes, the answer is, I've not read the actual survey, but I read the News Graphic coverage of the survey, of the story about the survey, and the outstanding or most obvious excerpt or the most obvious conclusion that the newspaper drew from the survey was in quoting Mayor Prather, who said that his two most expensive items in the town budget, the town of Georgetown budget, are number one, the payroll for all the employees, which includes the police, and number two, storm sewers. Those are the two biggest items in that Mayor Prather, to which Mayor Prather referred in his comments to the newspaper about the survey. And I wrote Mayor Prather a letter. I have not finished the letter and I haven't handed it to him yet, but I wrote Mayor Prather a letter in response to what he to this comment to the News Graphic, that his two major expenses are payroll and storm sewers. And I have long advocated, long before this survey was made, I have long advocated in Georgetown revegetation and reforestation of the town, not only for the timber that the trees would yield, and the beneficial vegetation that can be harvested for hay, for wild edible plants, for wildflowers, for all kinds of fiber uses, stuffing a mattress, for example, I have advocated revegetation and reforestation of Georgetown for the last, ever since I moved here in 19, since I moved back to Georgetown, my hometown, in 1990. I have advocated revegetation and reforestation. And as you may know, Mike Scoggin, or you may know James Scoggin, or as you people in the audience may know, trees delay rainfall. Trees delay snowfall. Vegetation does the same thing. Wild vegetation, a field of what people call weeds. When it rains, all that vegetation and all those trees slow the storm rainwater flow so that storm water does not build up and run laterally. In other words, by revegetating and reforesting Georgetown, the town could solve its stormwater problems without all the expense, which Mayor President said is his number two item outlay, his number two capital outlay is the storm sewers. If they would rely on revegetation, they wouldn't need to improve the storm sewers, and then the money that they would save, they could apply to the payroll. And what that money would probably go first to the police department, according to what I read in the newspaper. So by revegetating and reforesting Georgetown would solve both problems, maybe not solve the payroll problem, but go a long way toward solving the payroll problem, and would definitely relieve pressure on the storm sewers. Mike Scoggin and James Scoggin asked me for closing comments, and I would simply say that I'm concerned about the future of Georgetown, my hometown. I'm concerned that young people think that life is all about this. Motor driving, and their parents too, adults are the same way. They think that life is all a matter of motor driving and going shopping in order to survive. And my grandmother and people of her generation knew a lot better, because they taught me that life is a matter of this, working the ground to make crops, rather than this, to drive, to go shopping. And I'm going to do, if I get elected, or even if I don't get elected, I will continue to try to set the example that my grandmother and her generation set for me, which is raising crops, living off the land, instead of buying everything.